Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Welcome everybody. Welcome dear brothers and sisters inshallah. Today also, let's open our eyes to a very important thing, the animosity of the jinn and the shaitan to us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we talk about shaitan, in too many verses in the Holy Quran, he said shaitan is your, he is your enemy. Shaitan is your enemy. أَلَمْ أَعْهَدْ إِلَيْكُمْ يَا بَنِي آدَمَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا الشَّيْطَانِ إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ مُبِينٌ وَأَنْ اعْبُدُونِي هَذَا صِرَاطٌ مُسْتَقِيمٌ وَلَقَدْ أَضَلَّ مِنْكُمْ جِبِلًّا كَثِيرًا أَفَلَمْ تَكُونُوا تَعْقِلُونَ هَذِهِ جَهَنَّمُ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوعَدُونَ. فالله سبحانه وتعالى, when he talk about jinn, he said he's your manifest enemy. Enemy what? Why? Because he want to corrupt your life here in this worldly life, and also who want to corrupt your life, Taman, of course, in the hereafter, if he caused you and he advised you or he misguided you to do lots of good, bad deeds, and the end of that, it will be, wal'azu billah, the hell fire. You have to know, Shaitan, he does not want you to be, he don't want you to be strong. He's looking for your weakness, just always to be weak, to sit alone, don't talk with people, don't deal with others, and this is a sign of what? Shaitan. Shaitan's controlling that person. When you see somebody lonely all the time, sad all the time, he doesn't want to deal with others, he likes to stay alone, subhanAllah. Also, what we have to do to protect ourselves from that shaitan, what we have to do, that jinn, what we have to do, he's your enemy. Sometimes you see little girls or little boys or somebody, when he used to go to the bathroom or he's going to the bathroom, he stay long, long time there. You see women, sometimes they are looking to the mirror and staring to the mirror all the time. This is a bad sign. She likes to look to the mirror like this, and she's looking at herself or himself like that. Sometimes you see some men when stimulation, they make istimna or they, you know, they play their private parts or something like that too much in the bathroom when they go there. Also, they listen to the songs a lot, especially in the bathroom. Sometimes they are singing themselves in the bathroom. All of that stuff. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he asked us as Muslims, when you go to the bathroom, go enter with your left foot and say, A'udhu billahi min al-khubthi wal-khaba'ith. Means what? I seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the male and the female of what? Or the males or the females of jinn. Al-khubth means the males, Al-khaba'ith means the females of the jinn. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not allow them to see your body. Sometimes when you go to the bathroom, shaitan, they are male and female, boys and girls. When that brother who go to the bathroom, he did not mention the name of Allah and seek refuge from with Allah from these shaitan, they harm them. Because you're gonna be naked, taking shower in the bathroom, whatever. You see sometimes this jinni, males or females, they've been attracted by your body or something like that. Little by little, somehow they will go through your body and they will enter your body. Same thing with women, men and women. And they come to the level, they call the al-ishq. Al-ishq means love. You see that jinni, female, she loves that man. Or the jinni male, he loves that lady. And they try to enjoy their bodies like what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, يَا مَعْشَرِ الْجِنِّ قَدْ اسْتَكْثَرْتُ مِنَ الْإِنْسِ وَاسْتَمْتَعْ بَعْضُكُمْ بِبَعْضِ. Each one of you, ins and jinn, they enjoy each other's. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran. Also, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when you take your clothes off, say, بِسْمِكَ اللَّهُمَّ. Bismillah, mention the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some sisters, when they sit at home, they like to sit without like proper clothes. I know you are in your house, I know that, but sometimes you extremely you sit without, almost there is no clothes. And it is not the issue of your house. You are alone in your house or even in front of the kids. But the point here is the jinn. Jinn, they like to enjoy your body, especially when you sleep in your back. Sometimes they want to enjoy it. Sometimes you feel somebody touching your body. Sometimes you see that sometimes, like, you know, somebody pushing your body, touching your body, touching your private parts, touching your special parts of your body. This is jinn. Be careful. Be careful. And I'm sure some of you, they see all of that. Shaitan, he is so greedy and he likes to enjoy this, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, استمتع بعضكم ببعض. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ثم لآتي أنهم من بين أيديهم من خلفهم وعن أيمانهم وعن شمائلهم. Too many ayat talking about that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لأحتنكن ذريته إلى يوم القيامة. لأحتنكن ذريته إلى يوم القيامة. سبحان الله. وقال وشاركهم في الأموال والأولاد. Share them with their kids and their money and whatever. Sometimes the shaitan, when he comes to that, this sister, she doesn't have proper clothes and she sleep in her stomach all the time or in her back all the time without proper clothes and يعني, covering herself. You must cover yourself. يعني, بنت عوف ابن عفراء, that lady, she saw as if like shaitan above her body and is trying to do something with her. And she went to Aisha radiallahu anha, ibn Abi Dunya mentioned that, and Anas ibn Malik. She went to Aisha and she told her exactly, she told Aisha, the mother of the believers, this is what happened to me. I felt like somebody want to make intercourse with me, you know. And she said, don't worry about it, just shuddi alayki thawbik usturi nafsik, يعني cover yourself good. When you sleep, that's good. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect you. Sometimes some sisters, especially sisters, and some brothers also, you feel too many things in the, during the sleep. While you're sleeping, you feel somebody feeding you, and you see the taste of the food in your mouth. Shaitan make this for you. Also, sometimes you feel like blue marks in your body, especially in your shoulder, in your legs from down, on your back, and your chest sometimes, and your neck. You know, scratches, a lot of scratches. This is jinn. They do that to you while you are sleeping. Subhanallah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he said, لَمْ يَطْمِثْهُنَّ إِنْسٌ قَبْلَهُمْ وَلَا جَنْ دَحُورْ عِينِ جَنَّةِ No ins, no jinn touched them. See, it means the jinn, they can enjoy the human and they can enjoy each other. Also, السحر, that magic, you can also somebody can make it for you, or you in the food, or give it to you with the drink, or all of that stuff. Be careful, be careful. Sometimes the sign of that, when you see your body like very broken, you know, your body is so lazy, broken, you don't want to take shower, your body is very filthy, you know, it's bad smell and all that, all of this is the sign of jinn. You have a headache all the time, and subhanAllah, you cannot sleep, you cannot breathe. You like to sleep all the time, mostly. You're eating too much food. This, all of this, the sign of what? There is a jinn with you. There is a demon and jinn with you. Very important. If you see yourself, as I said, lonely, you don't want to talk to anybody, you don't want to deal with anybody, you're scared from people. You don't want to talk to the people. You hate to talk to the people. You're lonely. Subhanakot, this is all بسبب الجinn. Very important to know that. How to cure yourself? Very important, again and again and again. Zikr Allah, remembrance of Allah. Is salah, your prayer, very important. And buturuq al-shar'iyya. If your condition is so bad and you are in severe condition with this jinn and whatever, no. My advice to you, don't make ruq al-shar'iyya alone. Maybe jinn will harm you and he's gonna hurt you. It's better to go to somebody he knows how to deal with this, with the ruq al-shar'iyya and the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then they will help you little by little, inshallah, to get out of this problem. Otherwise, you can get just some olive oil and some rose water, and just put it and some misc, mix it together and wipe your body with this before you sleep and listen to ruqya al-shar'i. This is very important. This is just today how to know you have jinn, how to know how to deal with jinn, and very important we learn today. Sister, cover yourself. Sister, listen to the Quran, don't talk when you, while you are in the bathroom. If you see any one of these signs, which is, I said, laziness, and you like to be alone, you're a lot of depression, and all of this stuff, this is because of jinn. And also, there are too many things we still, inshallah, we're going to talk about it. From my experience and that knowledge, I'm like 25 years, I'm dealing with this, I'm breathing for people, and I know too many things. You, my job is to, I'm doing this video just for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, to advise you how to protect your family and your kids from this shaitan al-a'in, from the shaitan al-ins wal-jinn also, because shaitan al-ins wal-jinn, they are harming people, they are helping each other to harm the mu'mineen and the good people. Please share this video, let everybody know about this. Inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, and Allah will reward you because of that. As much as you can, send it to the people, email it to the people, and whatever, inshallah, you have WhatsApp, Facebook, Twitter, you can send this, let everybody know about it, inshallah. Maybe I will put my phone number under the this video, inshallah. If you have any question, just you can type it, you can just make like and subscribe and ring the bell. Also, whatever, inshallah, I'm doing, my lectures and the Quran will come to you, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. I love you all for the sake of Allah. To get more hasanat, more good deeds, try to help others also about this information. Just send this video to all what you know and spread these words. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah, will help others because of you, because too many people and too many cases of divorces and all of that problems in the houses because of this stuff and people doesn't know about it. Let everybody know what Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if you guide people to do something good, you are exactly gonna get the same reward similar to the one who did it. See you inshallah later and follow me. Inshallah, you will get more information. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.